In this tutorial, I want to show you a wonderful way to make your headshots pop using AI adaptive masks inside of Lightroom Classic. This is not a particularly difficult lesson, but I'm going to assume that you are already familiar with the way that AI-powered masks work throughout this video. If Lightroom's masking system, and in particular, what Adobe calls their people masking tool, is new for you, then please watch my in-depth video on that feature before you proceed with this lesson. For those who are familiar with how AI adaptive masks work, let's jump right into some portraits and let's get started. On the screen right now is a picture that I snapped one day of a friend while we were out skiing. In this photo, my subject has a good expression. The focus is sharp, but the light on his face is not strong enough. To fix that, I'm going to add three masks in Lightroom Classic. When the masking panel opens, I'm going to wait for Lightroom's face detection system, what Adobe calls their people mask feature, to identify the parts of his face. Once the AI has done its job, I'm going to click on person 1. Then, I'm going to include the parts of his face that I want inside this masking layer. To brighten up his face, I'll tap on the facial skin option. I'll also include his eyebrows, lips, teeth, and if he had a beard, I would choose the facial hair option as well. Next, I want to make sure that the option at the bottom that says create 4 separate masks is not active. Now that I have my mask, I'm going to add a hint of brighter light into his skin by moving the exposure slider up a smidge. I'm also going to add a small nudge into the shadows. If I click and hold the eyeball here, then you can see how these two little changes are making the light on his face much brighter. That's better, but I also want to add a hint of warmth in too. I can do that by moving down to the color pane and by bringing the temperature slider up a little bit. To see what we've accomplished with all of these adjustments, I can tap and hold on the eyeball up here at the top of the masking panel. That's a great start. So now I'm going to use the Create New Mask command and the Select People option again. I'm going to use the same settings that I did last time to create the same type of mask. To keep things clear, I'm going to take a moment to name these masks. This step is not mandatory, but it helps me keep track of what each layer does to improve the whole image. Now, since this is a picture of a manly man, I'm going to add some micro contrast into his skin on this masking layer. Adding a little texture and clarity is going to make the lines in his face appear sharper and more masculine. If this were a portrait of a woman, and if accentuating the skin texture were something that I wanted to avoid, then I might set the texture and clarity values to a negative number at this point. I'll show you what I mean by that in the next example. Let me make it clear that I typed in 15 for the texture and 10 for the clarity here without slowing down to consider if those are the perfect settings for this image. These numbers are just my default formula, but I promise that we will fine-tune these settings to better suit this particular image in just a minute. But first, let's add one more mask. For our third mask, I want to add some punch into his eyes. Fine-tuning the eyes separate from the skin allows for more precision, and that's important because in a headshot, the subject's eyes are the window to their soul. For the third mask, I'll tap on the Create Mask button. I'll use the Select People command. I'll pick Person 1, but this time, I'm only going to activate the Eye Sclera and the Iris and Pupil options. Once again, I'm going to leave the Create Separate Masks option turned off. Now, I'm going to dial in some tiny changes to the exposure, the contrast, and the shadow tone settings. I'm also going to add a tiny touch of saturation and a little texture and clarity. With these, his eyes should appear brighter, crisper, and more saturated. Let me split my screen at this point so you can see what we've accomplished using these masks. On the left is the image that we started with. And the one on the right is our almost finished product. I say almost finished because, in my opinion, things are a little overdone here. So let me go back to the single image view. And now, let's temporarily disable the top two masks. It's easy to overdo it when you're making these kind of changes, but there's an elegant way to make your masked alterations softer in Lightroom Classic. My favorite way to refine any change is to use the amount slider at the top of the masking panel, starting with our skin brightness layer. I'm going to move the amount slider up and down to increase or decrease the strength of the changes that this layer makes. On this image, I think that happens around the 40%. Now that its face is looking better, I'm going to reactivate the face micro contrast layer. Here, I'll repeat the amount slider process, make sure I'm on the right layer, until I'm adding just a hint of additional texture into his face. Finally, I'll do the same for the eye pop layer. When I get it right, the addition of light should be noticeable and pleasing, but not cartoonish. This looks good, so let me close the masking panel, and let me show you a final before and after. That's a much stronger portrait, and all it took were three simple masks. A few minutes ago, I mentioned that I usually use different settings for the skin micro contrast when working on portraits of ladies or children. Let me use this headshot to show you what I mean. Before I started recording this demo, I tuned up this raw file and I did everything that I could to improve the overall image. In addition, I've already added the same skin brightening mask that I used for the first steps on my previous example. This time, I'm going to take that face brightening mask and I'm going to duplicate it. In the last example, I ran the select people command a second time instead of duplicating my initial mask. Either method achieves the same result, but duplicating the first mask is a little faster. Let me rename this one so it's clear. But there's one catch. Whenever you duplicate a mask in Lightroom, it also duplicates all of the settings that were in place on the original one. That's why we're seeing an exposure and a shadows change here. Since those changes are not something that I want to repeat on this layer, I need to tap on the word reset at the far top right of the masking panel to zero out all these sliders. Now that all the adjustments have been reset, I can come down to the effects pane, but this time I'm going to set a negative value for the texture and the clarity. I can't explain why, but I also find that adding a tiny bit of negative dehaze gives female skin a soft, pleasing glow. To show you what's happening here, I'll press and hold on this eyeball. Nice. Now her skin looks a little softer, but not unrealistic. Let's finish things off by adding the same eye pop settings that I used on the last image. For that, I'll go Create New Mask. I'll go Select People. I'll go Person 1, and I'll activate only the Eye Sclera and Iris and Pupil options. Here, I'll key in the same settings that I used last time. And now, I'm going to split my screen so that you can see a before and after. On the left is the image with no masks, and on the right is our much improved version. But just like last time, I think that my initial changes with these masks are too strong. So I'm going to turn off the top two layers. I'll click on the bottom layer, and then I'll use the amount slider to make these changes stronger or weaker. On this image, I think that I need to add even more brightness than I had originally created. Next, I'll reactivate the face micro contrast and fine-tune its amount. Finally, I'll repeat this process one more time for her eye mask. There, that looks good. Let me close the masking panel, go back to single image view, and now I'll tap on the backslash key on my keyboard to show you a complete before and after. That's without our masks, and that's with. Fantastic. Well, there you go. I hope that you found this tutorial helpful. I hope that you've seen how adding three masks to any portrait can make your subject's face shine. If you learned something today, then please leave us a like or a comment down below. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.